So then we go to the synergy and results part of this thing. This is where you start the duplication. This is where your freedom kicks in. This is where your personal growth and you can get to do other opportunities and stuff. So then we go to the synergy and results part of this thing. This is where you start the duplication. This is where your freedom kicks in. This is where your personal growth and you can get to do other opportunities and stuff. Up until here where we get to team, what we're doing is buying back your time. We're making the extra money to hire the better people, to build the better system so that you can actually work less. Most of you understand this it's very simple. If you had better systems and better people, would you be working less? Yes or no?
Yes.
You have better marketing, better systems, and better team, would you be making more money? Absolutely. If you've got better mastery, the basics of the business, are you having to put out less fires and being more proactive? See, the first part of working with a coach is fixing the basics of the business, this mastery aspect down here. Once you've got the basics fixed, then it's time to do the fun stuff, you know? And sometimes fixing it'll take a month or two. Sometimes it takes 6, 12, even 18 months to get a business fixed. It depends on how badly you've messed it up, I guess, determines how long it takes to do that. Now, ultimately, then we go to the niche, and that could take 3, 6, 12 months. It could even take 2 years to get the marketing stuff right. Depends on how good your marketing is today and where you're at with it today. But then we go on to the systemization. Again, another 3 to 6 months, depending upon where you're at. Maybe bigger if you're in a bigger business. And then we go to the team building. Again, another 3 to 6 months. It takes time to do this stuff. A lot of people think that, hey, I'm looking for the silver bullet in business. I'm looking for that one idea that's going to save the whole thing. The reality of business is that you don't double a business with one idea. One idea doesn't add 100%. But 100 ideas that add 1%, this is how you double a business. It's the small changes along the way. This little small change, this little small change, they add up to massive change within the business. So Richard Branson, probably one of the most famous entrepreneurs worldwide, the Virgin brands, all of these things, he said it very, very simply. If I can, and this is the thing, what if I teach you how to run one business, can you then go and buy another business and do it again? If I teach you how to run a business, you can run as many of them as you want. You can run bigger ones than the one you're currently running. You can add zeros and upgrade to a bigger business, a better business than the one you're in. You know, but it's the learning of how to run the business that is what takes the time. The challenge is we didn't all have different jobs. We didn't have jobs in sales and marketing and all of these things to be trained by other people how to run our business. So we had to learn it along the way. One of my greatest mentors, Jim Rohn, and a very, very smart man. I was 16 years of age when I went to his first ever seminar. Pretty sure it changed the course of my life in the Brisbane City Town Hall. And I was sitting there as a 16-year-old, probably the youngest person in the room, taking notes hand over fist. But the two things that he said that stood out to me most. Number one, he said, never wish your life were easier, wish that you were better. See, don't wish business was easier, become a better business person. You know, don't wish that this thing is going to change, because it's not. It's just going to get harder and harder if you keep going down the same road. The reality of business is that the reason businesses keep disappearing is that the owners don't keep learning how to change and grow with the way the market is. Is business getting easier or harder out there? Which one, gang? Harder. There's more and more people wanting to compete with you. The economy gets tougher and tougher. There's more red tape. There's often more taxes, all of this sort of stuff. That doesn't mean we shouldn't do it though. It means we should learn how to do it better and how to do it more effectively. Second thing Jim Rohn said, work harder on yourself than you do on your job. Now I translate that to work harder on yourself than you do on your business. See, if you become a better business person, what all of a sudden happens? You build a better business. It's not rocket science, gang. This is a pretty easy way that we need to actually think about it. Building a business is not that hard if you know how. The challenge is how you're going to learn it. You're going to read all the books, are you going to go to do courses? Most of you don't have the time for that. But do you have time to meet with a coach every week? Do you have time to have someone work with you every single week? For most of us, the answer is yes. You know, I put it very, very simply. Where you get to in 5 years' time depends on the people you meet, the books you read, and the action you take. If you want to do the best decision you can, make a big decision. Take a big step. But working through the 6 steps is a very clear, systematic methodology. You know what a lot of business owners find when I show them the 6 steps? For the first time, they now actually have a plan how to get their business to work without them. For the first time, they now actually know how to make the business work so they don't have to. That's ultimately the goal. That's where we want you to get to, and that's why I started Action Coach. Hopefully you'll join us, and hopefully you'll understand how powerful these systems are for growing your business. Thanks, everyone.